The book, A Random Walk Down Wall Street, is a deep dive into the inner machinations of the stock market and the complex trading strategies that drive it. It's an interesting look at how, despite the volatility of the industry, some patterns are always bound to happen. On A Random Walk Down Hollywood, however, it would be easy to see that the only inevitable thing is that movie studios will always find a way to take the most successful intellectual property and milk it dry of all its novelty, then shove it down the throats of nostalgia-driven consumers. This year's iterations include a live-action Little Mermaid, another Peter Pan movie, the obligatory 100th sequel to your basic horror movie formula, old-school Saturday morning cartoons reimagined for modern America, your Cinematic Universe annual installments, and a fifth Indiana Jones? Really? The issue with this type of film is that it's unnecessary and it doesn't support any creativity or innovation in the industry. Why do we need to watch The Little Mermaid with real people in a poorly CGI'd ocean when they were able to achieve a far more creative and interesting work 30 years ago? There's nothing being added besides that awful Awkwafina song, if you could even call it a song. And all of its original charm is actually being detracted from it. And while movies like the Saw franchise follow the same basic plot and structures, new and original stories like Ari Aster's Beau is Afraid are pushed to the side and aren't given the same attention from both consumers and studios. This leads us to the topic of today's video, a movie that has the potential to be the most heartless and unnecessary of them all, the upcoming Wonka film. Based on some of the stuff I've seen coming from the movie's promotionals and trailers, it's looking like another cheap, star-studded cash grab whose only purpose is to arouse hype and nostalgia and get people in seats. There are numerous red flags rearing their ugly heads, and it's pretty clear from what they choose to show us that there's no substance to this at all. So let's just get into it.
I'm making chocolate, of course. How do you like it? Dark, white, nutty, absolutely insane.
First up is the most obvious issue, the casting. Timothy Chalamet does not sound like Wonka. He's doing this weird thing where all of his lines sound like he's loud whispering.
You see, I'm something of a magician, inventor, and chocolate maker.
Do you have a pencil and paper?
Uh-huh.
I got an idea.
My name is Willy Wonka.
And I know it's not fair to compare him, but this is something that comes up as a result of numerous remakes, sequels, and prequels. Anytime there are multiple actors portraying the same character, comparisons are bound to occur. Sometimes those actors amaze, and other times those actors are Jared Leto.
Really, really bad.
And when you are tasked with not only making the character your own, but topping the performances of Gene Wilder and Johnny Depp, while also attempting to replicate their mannerisms, you're not going to get a quality performance. And that's not all Timothy Chalamet's fault. He didn't write the script. There's clearly these shoehorned-in lines that are only there to remind the audience of the earlier movies.
Nope, scratch that, reverse it.
Wait a minute, strike that, reverse it.
Which makes it impossible to deliver them any better than what people's preconceived notions of how it should be delivered are. But, I mean, this is not the way to go about it. It sounds like he's attempting to sound dreamy, not whimsical. It's a somewhat flirtatious approach. I don't like it, it makes me feel weird.
You see, I'm something of a magician, inventor, and chocolate maker.
Going off of that, it's pretty clear that this movie is going to be heavily influenced in quotation marks, by the earlier two movies. We see that the Oompa Loompas are going to look identical to the 1971 film, and are going to be played by a CGI'd Hugh Grant instead of giving the acting job to a real little person, and we already noted how they are directly referencing that movie with the scratch that, reverse it line. This further tells me that the movie's whole goal is to make you feel like you're watching your favorite iconic chocolate movie. It's nostalgia bait. Not only that, but the trailer music references the Pure Imagination song, but epic trailer musicified.
Good. Too good.
Pretty sure I've gained about 150 pounds in the last 2 weeks.
In a world of pure imagination, take a look.
Everything they're showing us is pointing to them chasing the feelings from the earlier movies and not setting itself apart. The real issues arise when you realize that this new story is not based on any Roald Dahl novel like the other two were. This is an original story with original characters and ideas. So why are you upset? Isn't that what you want for some originality? I'm sure that I would love the story about a chocolatier magician going up against the chocolate cartel. My problem is, why are they pretending that it's all related to Willy Wonka? If it were really trying to be original, then why adapt it to an established intellectual property? The reason is money. They're willing to creatively shoot themselves in the foot because they believe it'll earn them more money. And they're right! If they made a movie called Jimmy Newman, Chocolate Guy, then nobody would come to see it, even if it was a masterpiece, because that's unfamiliar to them. People love doing things that feel familiar, that make them feel safe. And honestly, it's hurting the industry. Now, all that being said, it could still be a good original story and a somewhat enjoyable movie to watch. I've seen a lot of movies with bad trailers that turn out to be interesting, thought-provoking films. In fact, most movie trailers are terrible nowadays. They're too long and give away too much of the movie, and always use that obnoxious, epic trailer music. But I digress. Honestly, seeing that it comes from Paul King, director of the Paddington movies, is heartening. And while the trailers don't offer much hope, I've seen Timothy Chalamet perform well in good roles, so it's possible he's not unbearable. All in all, this could be a charming adventure. But it won't be, because it's a Willy Wonka movie. So to recap, Timothy Chalamet will be kinda lame, the writing will rely too heavily on nostalgia, and the story will be completely disconnected from its original IP, making it completely unnecessary. Oh yeah, and one more prediction. I've been noticing a trend of prequels explaining the origins of people's names for no reason.
I'm alone.
Solo.
It's a small weird thing, but it happens pretty often, so I'm predicting there will be some scene where the Oompa Loompa says, Oompa means friend, and Loompa means chocolate, or something to that effect. I guess we'll have to wait until December to find out. Thank you for watching, and Hollywood, if you're listening to this, please write something original.
Oompa Loompa, Doompa Dee Da. If you're not greedy, you will go far. You